I want to correct. I talked about women being given money to run for office. And the thing is, when we're talking about politics and campaigning, we need to change how we look at campaign financing. Because our politics is so deliberately expensive to the point that even if you have the leadership skills that you need and you don't have the money, you will not run for office. So that means that it excludes people with the leadership that we need. So I think even as we give the women the money, we also need to be very serious and very deliberate about campaign financing. And we need to put a cap on how much a governor can spend campaigning, how much a member of parliament can spend campaigning, how much an MCA can spend. And if you exceed that amount, then you need to explain to people, where did you get that money? Because if you cannot explain where you get the money, then it means that we're going to attract corrupt people. We will attract people with questionable sources of income. And that now becomes now a whole leadership problem. Now, I just needed to say that to get it out because I felt like I misled people and I left it hanging.
Yeah.
Now, to answer your question on whether women are judged differently, of course women are judged differently because we have social and cultural factors that hold us at different standards. There's a way a woman is supposed to behave. You're supposed to just, you know, be nice and feminine, and we have determined what is feminine and what is masculine. So to be loud and opinionated and out there and occupying space is a masculine thing. And for women, you're supposed to be like this, you sit down, you do this and that and the other, and that affects even how we look at leadership. So when it comes also to what she said about flower girls, I really believe in affirmative action. I believe that women need these nominated seats because it's important that women associate leadership. I mean, it's important that people, the majority of the population, associate leadership to women. And that is where, for me, the nomination comes in. And also the standards needs to be the same. You can't say that a woman is not performing. Also, the thing about having, the thing about giving women seats, we need to ask who is giving these seats. Because many people will say, oh, you were given a nomination seat. Okay, so you have already established that I have been given this seat. So someone owns this seat. Why are we not questioning the people who own this seat? Because if you own the seat, then it means that I have to play by your game. And playing by your game then will make me be called a flower girl. Because I don't have, fine, yes, I have the seat, but I don't really have the real power. Because if you gave me the seat, then you can take it away from me. If I say something out of line, if I color just slightly out of the line, you will take it away from me. So I have to play by the rules. And most of those rules are patriarchal. Rules. Like she talked about who owns the political party. The political party is one that comes up with the nomination list. And we know the politics around nomination. We know sometimes you have to sleep with someone. Sometimes your husband has to give money to someone who will give money to. It's a whole network of patriarchy and a whole network of men who hold this power. So the women who are allowed in these spaces, and I'm using allowed very deliberately, they are allowed by someone with the power. So this person plays the flute and you dance. When they stop playing, you stop dancing. When they start playing again, you start dancing. So it's let me just
Anita, what do you think?